Measurements are ubiquitous. We consider them in the supermarket to buy the ingredients for our favorite dish. But most importantly, the technology around us measures too many things to know where we are, how the weather is, or even to help us improve our health. Hi, my name is Israel, and today we're going to talk about metrology. Metrology is the science of measurement and its applications. This means it's an area of knowledge that focuses on the study of the theoretical and practical aspects of measurements. But the question now is, what's a measurement? According to the International Vocabulary of Metrology, measurement is the process of experimentally obtaining one or more quantity values that can reasonably be attributed to a quantity. This process is performed by comparing the physical magnitude of the object or phenomenon with a reference unit by using a measuring instrument or a measuring system. The measurements can be used to perform data analysis, monitor a process, or even control it by providing a feedback. Now it's necessary to know what these physical quantities and reference units are. For this, we must talk about the BIPM, the Bureau International des Poids et Mesures, the International Bureau of Weights and Measures. It was born from the Meter Convention in 1875, and it's located on the outskirts of Paris. The BIPM defines the International System of Units, the SI, that has seven fundamental physical quantities with their corresponding base units. There we can find the mass with the kilogram as base unit, length with the meter, time with the second, electric current with the ampere, thermodynamic temperature with the Kelvin, amount of substance with the mole, and finally, luminous intensity with the candela. As of May 2019, all base units are defined by seven universal constants that are present in nature and are the same everywhere. Before this, some of the fundamental units were defined from physical objects serving as measurement standards. For example, the kilogram was defined with a platinum-iridium alloy cylinder, known as the International Prototype of the Kilogram, the IPK. If we combine the base units using multiplications and divisions, we can get derived units that allow us to describe the entire universe. Some of these have specific names, such as the coulomb, to measure the electric charge that results from the ampere second. On the other hand, the unit of area does not have a specific name, and it's just square meter. The SI also makes use of prefixes that represent decimal multiples and submultiples of the different units. For example, I can measure the activation time of a transistor in nanoseconds, the weight of an insect in micrograms, or the distance from Geneva to Paris in kilometers. In addition to the International System of Units, the BIPM also ensures traceability, a concept that can be seen in the following way. If I have a measuring instrument, and I want to validate the quality of its measurement, I can take it to a laboratory to certify it. There they will perform a measurement procedure to compare the indication of my instrument with their measurement standard. This quantification process is known as calibration. Once the calibration value, curve, or table, along with the corresponding uncertainties are known, if it's outside a specific tolerance range, the measurement can be corrected by adjusting my instrument. It's also important that the measurement standards and procedures of these laboratories are calibrated and accredited by the corresponding national institutes, who handle the national or primary measurement standard. For example, the National Institute of Standards and Technology in the US, the Centro Nacional de Metrología in Mexico, or the Physikalisch-Technische Bundesanstalt in Germany. Finally, the BIPM also ensures that the national measurement procedures and standards are reliable, thereby providing an international standard. In summary, this means that all measurement results are validated through a chain of calibrations or comparisons to an international measurement standard where the highest hierarchy is the BIPM. Speaking of standards, calibration and traceability are defined by the ISO IEC 17025 standard. ISO is the International Organization for Standardization. It unifies industrial standards and is well known because of the ISO 9001 certification that refers to quality management. The IEC is the International Electrotechnical Commission that publishes standards for electrical and electronic technologies. Both the ISO and the IEC are located in Geneva, Switzerland. In addition, there are some other national standards organizations affiliated to ISO, like ANSI in the US, DIN in Germany, or the DGN in Mexico. Other highly known specific international organizations are the IEEE, NEMA, or the OIML. There are fundamental concepts when talking about metrology that somehow I have already mentioned in terms of the quality of a measurement. They are accuracy, trueness, precision, uncertainty, and error. I will give an example on how to get them and analyze them in a following video. These concepts are also officially defined in different documents and standards, such as the International Vocabulary of Metrology and the Guide to the Expression of Uncertainty in Measurement. Both documents are written by the Joint Committee for Guides in Metrology and serve as reference for the Guide 99 of the ISO and the IEC. The standards ISO 3534, ISO 57025, or IEC 60050 provide more details on these concepts and measuring instruments. To conclude, here are some interesting facts and a question you can answer in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.